Okay, so this is problem 5-4 in the book, and it just asks you to draw free body diagrams for all these different structures. So we'll start with that. In the first one, you can see the body that we're interested in would be A to B. So I'm going to idealize that by simply drawing a kind of a simple line diagram. And now I'm going to put on the things that I know for sure are happening. So right here in the middle, I have an applied force of 100 pounds. And at this particular bend, this elbow, there's a moment of 200 pound feet. I'll go ahead and transfer my dimensions. So I know this is 3 feet, 3 feet, this length is 2 feet. And now let's put on the reactions. So B, this is a smooth contact. So I'll draw on this one just to let you know. We want the reactive force to be perpendicular. So when I draw this force over here, and I'll just call it B, I should be able to, because it's perpendicular, take this slope of 12 to 5 and change that to 5 to 12. Way it's perpendicular to that surface. I also have this collar system, and you might remember the way this is drawn, this is going to provide some resistance for rotation. So I'll have, I'll assume that I have a moment there, I'll call that my moment at B, and that I also have, again, perpendicular to this, will be a reaction, I'll call it A. Didn't do a very good job there. Let me extend that so I can show you that what used to be horizontal 3 to vertical 4 is now flipped so that I'm now perpendicular. And that's it. So how many unknowns do I have? Well, I have my unknown force at A. Oh, this is a moment. I said B. This would be a moment at A, right? A moment at A, and then this unknown force I call B. 1, 2, 3 unknowns. Any questions about that? Yeah. Say then, what about A? The way this is drawn here, you see the way it looks like it's welded and fixed together? If you saw a pin there, then there would be no moment. So you kind of have to pay attention to these, the connections. Oddly, and I think that's the way it looks. That's the way it looks to me. I don't see a pin. Do you guys see a pin? Oh, the point does slide up and down, but the bar cannot rotate. But it's welded on. So the whole system could just lift, could slide up and down like this, right? It could actually lift off of B. So the second one is a crane system, and I think what we want to do is draw a free body diagram for the entire crane system. Okay? So I'm going to kind of idealize the crane as, so the body of the crane would be something like this, and then it's attached to a boom that looks something like that. I know that I have a center of gravity point, so acting at that center of gravity, I would have whatever the mass vector was. I'll just call it the weight. From my dimensions here, I know the boom is at some angle theta. I know these lengths of the boom are, looks like 6 meters and 6 meters. And then where it contacts down through the body, I have 2 meters, another center of gravity, which is a meter, and another meter at a contact point here at B, and a contact point here at A. Not doing a very good job with the dimensions, but I think you get the idea. So what happens? Well, this foot of the tripod, the supporting mechanism, pushes down. It acts just in one direction, reaction at A and reaction at B. That's it. No other part of the object, the free body, touches the surface. Both these forces are perpendicular to the surface. I forgot to add the other weight force. And then out here at the tip would be whatever the load is, I'll just call it F. So what do we have? We've got a force at the tip of the boom. We've got the weight of the boom, the weight of the supporting structure, or the truck. And then we have these reactive forces. There's only two unknowns here. The truck tires are off the ground, so you have to be careful when you do these that you don't apply so much force that this force at A becomes negative. What happens if the force at A becomes negative? That means that part of the truck is picking up off the ground, right? And we don't have the ability to have tension to pull it back down. So you could actually, under these circumstances, design what the maximum force F would be by assuming that this force here was equal to zero. So that's another way. So you can make sure that your crane or your boom doesn't tip. Any questions about that? All right, this particular problem, 5.4, actually has four parts, so I've got to pull this out of the way and put in the second set. So the third question in this sequence, it's going to be a lot easier to draw, so I'll just draw my rigid body. There it is. So what are the forces acting on this rigid body? What's happening here at A? Well, you'll notice I have a contact point on the horizontal surface and a contact point on the vertical surface. So that means I should have a reaction perpendicular to the horizontal surface. I'll call that A in the y direction, and then I'll have another one perpendicular to the x surface. I should also write my geometry so I know this length AB is at 30 degrees from the horizontal. It has a length of 4 meters. Now, what is the reaction at B? Again, it's a smooth contact point, so I should be perpendicular to that. So I know the direction B. So now you just have to think about the geometry here. I'll draw this line. That's the line it's acting perpendicular to, and of course to the horizontal, that's 60 degrees. So the geometry should tell you what you need, for example, what what this angle would be. You guys figure out what that would be? Hmm? 30 degrees, yeah. Now you have all the parts you want. Again, you have two unknowns at A, one unknown at B, three unknowns, you should be able to write three equations. So the last one in this sequence is a very odd looking thing. It looks like some kind of lever that's free to move, but you can see it's restrained here at the end, and this is a special kind of spring. This is a spring that's a kind of rotational or torsional spring. So you'll notice that the moment applied here is a function of the angle. So just like a spring, as you stretch a normal linear spring, you get a force. This spring is, as you rotate it, you generate a moment. So again, I'll draw the free body. There it is. So what's acting on this free body? This is a pin, right? So I still have to consider that I have a vertical and a horizontal component. And then what else do I get? Well, this spring is reacting to the rotation. So I need to put that in there. So I would then write that I have a moment that's equal to 20 theta. And that's applied. That's not a reaction, right? That means when I rotate this so many angles theta, I'm generating that moment. Now the one thing that we may not have considered here, and I'll just add it as kind of an aside, is that the body may have some weight. But that's really not part of the problem. So I have these two forces and I have the weight. And it's at some position. Any questions about that? Okay.